What do you want? It was a question that Jesus asked every single blind guy he met. Isn't that crazy? Can you imagine the blind guy standing at the gates going like, I'm blind, I'm blind, I'm blind. And Jesus says, what do you want? He's like, duh. I don't think Jesus was confused. Again, I think he wants to know from that guy what he wants to know from you, what he wants to know from me. What do you want? And if you want a Porsche, just get it out there. I want a Porsche. You're not getting one, but get it out there anyway. We don't need a bunch of pageant kind of responses. I want world peace. If that's not what you want, God's not dazzled by these big statements. What he's dazzled by is humble, authentic hearts. Make yours one of them. And the way to get there is to just get real about what you want. And it's going to take a little bit of pinging of that. And by pinging, I mean this. What we've done is we've lived our whole lives surrounded by people who weren't trying to mess with our heads, but they were telling us what we want. It was a parent, it was an old boyfriend or girlfriend, it was a pastor, it was a friend, it was somebody, they told you what you want, and down deep you go like, I actually don't want that. Boy, I'm telling you, could you just clear the decks, spread it all out and say, what do I want? And if faith isn't even a big deal for you, don't put in a Sunday school answer to say like, well, Jesus, if that's not what you want, get real with that. But I'm telling you, if you're on this road towards faith and you actually want more faith in your life, just get that out there. Jesus never had a problem with people who were confused. What bugged him was the people who were faking it. People were saying, I want this, but they really want something different. If this group that you're with in right now can just get real about who you are, where you are, and what you want, you'll be way ahead on the track to figuring out your ambitions, how to get after it, and dreaming big dreams.